Alright, back with this black-white Mimic Vat update. I'm actually going to end up doing a couple of 8-mans rather than a daily this time because this is a deck that, like, refreshing it basically is going to take a little bit of work, I think. We might get it right on the first try, we might not, but I would like to, like, maybe update it twice if we find something that we don't like in the deck, or if we, have another idea for the deck or whatever. So rather than playing one daily, I'd rather do a couple of 8-mans and give you guys the same amount of matches, maybe even more if we win both of them. But also be able to update the deck again if we find something super crazy or whatever. Might take me a little bit longer, but that's okay. Anyway, so one of the problems with the deck that we're not going to really be able to fix too much is the mana. Black White just doesn't have a lot of mana fixing. We added a third Terramorphic Expanse, so we have three of these in here. Still the four Marsh Flats, and then we did add one Prophetic Prism. I would add more prisms, but it's really hard to fit the card in there when you just need a higher density of business spells since you don't have a lot of card draw. And we actually took out the Sign of Bloods. I like Sign of Blood, but it's double black, which is a little awkward for the deck. And we added the Squadron Hawks that I'll get to a little bit later instead. But other than that, we still have four Tech Edges. I understand the mana is not the greatest, but we pretty much need these to deal with decks like Valakut or Man Lands that we really don't have too many answers to because Doomblade doesn't deal with Creeping Tarbit, which is one of the more popular ones. And beyond that, we really just are blocking or whatever. We have, like, Hex Mages to attack into it, and then they can't block with their guy or whatever. But Journey to Nowhere is not an instant speed answer, and we're actually eschewing Disfigures from the deck just because I think we should have a good enough, like, game against super aggressive decks that we don't need them. But then we added 5 1-mana discard effects. This is kind of to fight Planeswalkers, counter magic, and various Valakut ramp spells or whatever, help out a little bit there. Two Inquisitions, usually you go 3 Inquisitions, 2 Duress right now, but because we have so many cards against aggro already, I think the Duress is going to be better, just deal with Jaces or other Planeswalkers, things like that. But if you wanted to go 3 Inquisition, 2 Duress, that's fine, I think. Still 2 Ratchabombs, just kind of a catch-all to deal with Luminarch Ascensions or whatever out of the main deck since Blue-White is a real deck right now. I don't know if we need them, but we're gonna keep them in there. Last time we played against a bunch of Valakut and Eldrazi Green, so obviously it wasn't that exciting there, but I think that they'll end up being needed. Still, we kept 3 Doomblades. We cut the Grasp of Darkness, but we left 3 Doomblades in. I like the instant speed nature of it, and the fact that it triggers a Mimic Vat. Journey to Nowhere doesn't trigger Mimic Vat, but it gives us ways of dealing with like Blood Gas and Vengevines and things like that when we don't have Mimic Vat in play. And overall, I think the Journeys are a nice catch-all for the deck. Squadron Hawks in here to deal with control decks because we were having some issues with control decks. This card's actually pretty insane against them. You just go like turn 2 Squadron Hawk, and if it does not counter it or whatever, then you have this relentless group of 1/1 flyers that they have to start wasting their removal on. So I like Squadron Hawks a lot in the deck. We kind of replaced the Sign of Bloods with them. Similar card advantage. They're fine on a Mimic Vat or whatever. Not super exciting, but we're going to try them out. And then the other 2-drop against control, and it's actually okay against aggro too, just because it's first strike, is Vampire Hexmage, able to fight Planeswalkers, awesome on a Mimic Vat or whatever. So we're going to try that out. And then we have the 2-drop against aggro, which is Wall of Omens, again, fine on Mimic Vat. We lowered our curve a lot too by adding all these 2-drops, and it looks like there's a lot of 2-drops in the deck, but in reality, like, some of these things are not 2-drops. Like Doomblade, you're rarely going to play on 2. Journey Nowhere is the same way. Squadron Hawk, Hexmage, and Wall of Omens, you can pretty much play at any point in the game and get some value out of it. So we're not really like trying to play all these cards on turn 2. Mimic Vats, the namesake of the deck, pretty explanatory. We left 2 Day of Judgments in the main. I don't think we need 3. We have a third in the sideboard, but 2 seems fine. Left 1 Gideon in the deck. He's like pretty decent alternate win condition, and he's fine against creature decks, so we left him in. 2 Grave Titans, 1 Sun Titan. Sun Titan gets back Mimic Vats or Ratchet Bombs or Hex Mages or Wall of Omens or Squadron Hawk or Tectonic Edge, so we're going to try him out. I had 3 Grave Titans in the deck for a while, but I want to try out 1 Admonition Angel since we're kind of, playing a little bit of a quirky deck. Might as well try this guy out. He's pretty good against Valakut and the fact that he can remove their Valakuts from the game, and he's kind of a big dude, or remove mountains from the game, whatever. We're up to 7 Fetch Lands, so we can realistically trigger him twice in a turn. And yeah, he's just a big 6/6 flyer, so we're going to try him out. Sideboard, we have a couple Purge, couple Revoke Existence. These things are like good against Pyromancer Ascension. Celestial Purge, pretty good against Vampires. Not much to say there. The 4th Mimic Vat's pretty much for Vengevine decks exclusively. We could do something like Nihil Spellbomb or whatever, but I think Mimic Vat's overall going to be better, especially since we have the Journey to Nowhere in the main deck. Liliana Spectre complements our new game plan of like Hawks and Hex Mages against Control, because then you have like a 2-drop that impacts the board against them, followed by a 3-drop that impacts the board against them, and all those things are fine under Mimic Vat too, so it's kind of like some extra added pressure against Control. A Day Judgment, 2 Skinrenders, or just a few more aggro things in case, like for Swarm decks, White Weenie, Vampires, whatever. Then 3-member side, which is obviously in there for Valakut or Pyromancer Ascension or Eldrazi Green or any of those types of decks. We might end up needing a little bit more against Control, but I think we added enough that our Control matchup should be pretty decent now. But yeah, so we're gonna jam this through a couple 8-mans and see how it works out. We'll be right back with round 1.